these the best available seats? Must say I prefer to sit nearer the front. I say I would prefer to sit nearer the front. Since nobody appears to be moving, I suppose we shall have to make do.
Goodness me. Somebody forgot to wash. Oof. For a boy of 17, you show a lamentable lack of curiosity. No doubt you're suppressed by your upbringing, but that's hardly enough to explain what frankly amounts to little short of social autism. I shall have to imagine your curiosity for you. You're a healthy 17-year-old boy. You're not, of course. Do you take my point? You see an attractive woman living on her own, you wonder. Is she a roaring lesbian? Answer no. For your information, I've been married and divorced 3 times. Once to an actor, once to an English lord, and once to a Californian. All work things. My mistake. You, on the other hand, might well be gay. I must introduce you to Doom. Old agent friend of mine. Obviously queer, of course, but the old-fashioned type. Bent gent.
I'm not gay.
I beg your pardon?
I'm not gay.
Not gay, Curly.
Can I help?
I wish to see your equipment.
My equipment?
Show me everything you've got. Your lady! Ben, can you put your shoulder under my arse? Always dreamed of camping, even as a child. Half in, half out. Of course, my parents would never have dreamt of it. The lower middle classes are the worst snobs. You sound faintly Cockney, are you?
No.
No. What are you, really?
I don't know. Middle class, I suppose.
Where on earth have you been? It's 6 o'clock.
Got held up.
Got held up. We had a driving lesson at 4. You should have let me know.
There was nowhere to call from. If I had a mobile...
Mobiles give you cancer.
Sorry.
You do not touch my things.
I was tidying.
You do not touch my things.
Yes, I'm sorry. I'm very sorry. My sister. My sister.
Oh, my dear Orchard. My sweet and lovely Orchard. My youth. My happiness. Farewell. Farewell. Kill me tomorrow. Let me live tonight.
Nay, and you strive.
But half an hour.
Being done, there is no pause.
But while I say one prayer.
'Tis too late.
Lord. Oh. Born to it. Absolutely born to it.
We did Othello at school. It wasn't like, I mean, it wasn't very good. The thing is, you don't understand the jealousy bit till you actually strangle someone yourself.
Ah, there you see. The poetry, the pain.
I write poetry.
How intriguing. May I hear one?
Oh, I'm not. I mean, I don't know any off by heart.
Another time, perhaps. Now then, I was thinking we could go camping tomorrow.
Camping? Why on earth would anyone want to go camping?
to escape?
He can't, possibly. He's got a dress rehearsal with the guides next week.
He's a tree.
A eucalyptus tree. Plus, he's got Bible club and his driving lessons to think about.
But I thought you were teaching him.
Precisely.
Well, surely a few days is hardly going to make any difference.
Robin, you're not the one trying to run the Girl Guides, organize a play, keep house and look after half the over 70s in Finchley.
Sorry, but what does any of that have to do with Ben?
I need him here.
Hello?
Mum.
Ben, where are you? I was expecting you at 6.
I'm on a campsite. Evie swallowed the car key and now we can't get back till she poos it out. Mum? You there?
I'm calling the police. Where are you?
I don't know. Don't call the police. I'm fine, really.
Have you taken a tablet, Ben? Try to think. Did she give you a tablet? Something for a headache?
I'm fine. I just can't come back till morning.
Robert, she's kidnapped him. He's somewhere on a campsite. He sounds drugged.
Mum, I'm fine, honestly.
Don't move. I'm on my way.
Mum, there's nothing wrong with me. I'm stuck on a campsite and I can't come back till morning.
Whenever you can get back. Good night, Ben.
Mum? Mum?
Miss Walton.
I'm she.
Hello, welcome to Edinburgh. I'm Bryony. I'm helping on the Literary Festival. Did you have a good journey up?
As good as can be expected. Ben, my assistant, drove me.
I'm afraid we hadn't allowed for an assistant.
No, no. I'll take care of that.
I take it that's a no, then.
It's 11:30.
So?
I promised Evie I'd be there by 11.
She can go on her own, can't she?
She won't go on without me.
You're kidding, right?
She means it. I have to be there before she goes on, or she can't remember her lines.
Ben, she's reading from a book.
Makes a difference. She's completely hopeless unless I'm in the same room.
Isn't that a bit weird?
She's not weird. She's just nervous.
Relax, she's having you on.
No, she isn't. I promised her I'd be there. Once you've made a promise, you should keep it.
You don't have to tell me what happened. I know already. Some people are wicked. And that's all there is to it.
She isn't wicked.
She's an actress! I think that says enough. Of course, I blame myself for suggesting we try and do something kind for Mr. Fincham. This is the thanks I get. My child on drugs. Probably abused.
I wasn't abused. I had a really good time.
When you went with that actress, you left God's house. While there is breath in my body, you will not leave it again. Look at me when I'm talking to you.
We are gonna stop here. I hope you enjoyed what you have seen. There is more to come. There are a couple of interesting, actually, twists still yet to come in this film. So go ahead, rent it or buy it if you like to add it to your collection. I think this film does have some good humor, has a good message, and also have some depth into the characters. So overall, it's a film that well worth watching, despite that the story may not be a new story. That was the International Film Club for this week. Thank you for watching, and till we meet again, have a good one.